When your heart gets restless, time to move along. When your heart gets weary, time to sing a song. But when a dream is calling you, there's just one thing that you can do. Well, you gotta follow that dream wherever that dream may lead. You gotta follow that dream to find the love you need. Keep on moving, I move along. Keep on moving. Gotta find me someone whose heart is free. Someone to look for my dream with me. And when I find her, I may find out just what my dreams are all about. I've gotta follow that dream wherever that dream may lead. I gotta follow that dream to find the love I need. I've gotta follow that dream wherever that dream may lead. I gotta follow that dream to find the love I need. Keep moving, move along.
So the floor, the walls, the ceiling, the lamps, everything was put on by Marion Kaisker and Sam Phillips. Sam Phillips designed it himself, so that's pretty cool. And Marion Kaisker hand-painted each one of those blocks herself. I told you she was more than a secretary, right? And the instruments are not original because we're still a recording studio at night, so people still come here almost every night and use those instruments to record. Yep. So we just asked to resist the temptation to touch the instruments, but other than that, you can turn your flashes on, your videos on if you want, just rock and roll. Yeah, and going back to the story I was telling you guys upstairs, one year after I was came here recording My Happiness, for the first time, he came here the first time, Sam Phillips was putting together a band with Scotty Moore and Bill Black, and he needed a lead singer for that band. At that point, Marion Kaisker had been begging him for over a year to call Elvis, so Sam Phillips finally gave up. Yeah, she called Elvis. When he got here, he saw Scotty Moore on The X playing electric guitar. I want to be Scotty Moore, man. Oh,
yeah,
sorry, it's Scotty Moore playing electric guitar. Bill Black on The X. Want to be Bill Black? Yeah, Bill Black. Playing bass.
Right there.
Now, right here. Want to be Elvis?
Oh, well, that's not a question.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's right, baby. And actually, this part here is so special that when Bob Dylan came here, he didn't say a word to anyone. He just walked in, kissed The X, and left without saying anything. So if anyone wants to be Bob Dylan, I guess. But I just wouldn't recommend. But anyway, so they went on to play for hours and hours, all kinds of music that they knew. Sam Phillips still wasn't impressed. So told the guys to go on a break, which is basically the code for you failed the audition, as far as I know. The guys there started packing their instruments to leave. Elvis, though, he knew it was his only chance with Sam Phillips, so he kept playing. He actually started playing this very obscure song by this very obscure blues artist called Arthur Big Bark Crudup, and the song was "That's Alright, Mama." There was only one person in this room who knew that song. It was Sam Phillips. He was a blues fan just like Elvis, right, Elvis? Yeah, he's like, so Sam Phillips was right there, ran through that door, yelled at Elvis, said, "Elvis, didn't know you knew that song. Keep playing it, but play it in a faster rhythm, in a rock and roll style." Told the guys to unpack their instruments and play with Elvis. Those guys had never heard that song before, but they recorded "That's Alright" right away in 2 takes.
Wow. Wow.
Just like that. So wow. On the same night, Sam Phillips took the recording to that man, this Dewey Phillips, the DJ that I told you guys upstairs, and 3 nights later, finally, Dewey Phillips played "That's Alright" for the first time on his radio show. So if you guys were listening to his radio show, Red Hot and Blue, on the night of July 8th, 1954, this is what you would hear. Let me just warn you, though, that he had a very thick southern accent. So if you don't understand what he says, it's like, I'm from Brazil, so it took me a while to understand, so don't worry.
Good people, so Phillips, let's bring the hottest cotton picking thing to cuts a red hot blue coming through WHBQ and Hotel Chisca on the magazine floor. It's right there.
That's right, Putty called Sam, Putney.
No, I gotta call Sam, dear.
Ah, Pete Picker.
Hey, get along there, Earn. Didn't see Earn. How you doing, buddy?
Pretty good, Putney. It's more like it. All right, it's okay, nervous?
Nope.
All right. Just go on down and get you a wheelbarrow load of mad dogs, run them through the front door, and tell them Philip sent you for it. Hot.
I got a new song we're gonna play here. They're gonna cut loose this new song. I mean, it'll flat get it.
Well, that's all right, Mama. That's all right for you. That's all right, Mama. Just any way you do it, that's all right. That's all right.
Everyone loved it. They loved it so much, like I said, upstairs. They kept calling and requesting that song. Dewey Phillips played it 14 times in a row on that night. And Elvis was downtown watching a movie, a cowboy movie, so they had to find him, get him out of the movie, should be interviewed for the first time. That, like I said, on the same night. So Sam Phillips signed Elvis right away for a 3-year contract, but that contract didn't last more than 17 months. Because at some point Elvis was starting to become so famous, and Sam Phillips knew that financially couldn't keep up with it. Couldn't make Elvis the king of rock and roll because he didn't have the money to promote him. So he decided to sell Elvis's contract to RCA Victor, and then with the money that he got from selling the contract, he was able to sign more artists. And one artist to be signed after that was that man with the shades, Roy Orbison. That's right. He had a hit here, a cool dance song called Ooby Dooby. That was pretty cool. And also, Carl Perkins, ladies and gentlemen, he went on to be a huge influence on the Beatles, especially George Harrison. George Harrison was a huge Carl Perkins fan. And also, Carl gave Sam its first gold record.
Blues Way Shoes.
Thank you so much. Wow. Actually, you said it so fast that I'm going to give you a pick for that answer. There you go.
Thank you very much. Thank
you. You're welcome.
That's what I'm looking for.
Here's the story. At that time, country music and drums didn't get along together because people thought drums were too rock and roll. For country music, in most places, wouldn't even let you play if you had a drum set on stage. So Johnny Cash, he wanted to play the Grand Ole Opry, and he also wanted the snare sound on his music. So Sam Phillips came up with this idea so Johnny Cash wouldn't need a drum set. All he needed to do was place a piece of paper on the acoustic guitar. He put it all up here just because it fits perfectly. But he needed to do it with any piece of paper. Have y'all seen the movie? Walk the Line?
Yeah.
So in the movie, they briefly show him playing with the dollar bill. But that's just because the people of the movie came here and saw our dollar bills, so that got a little bit out of hand. But he used to do it with any piece of paper. He would loosen up the strings like this and just play it. So this is what you hear on his music.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tide is fine. Because you're mine, I want the line.
Yay! Maroon 5 back, all kinds of. Last year we had Chris Isaak. He recorded here with Scotty Moore. Scotty Moore came back and recorded here, so that was pretty cool. So what I'm trying to say is, this is not just a museum. We're still rocking and rolling. Like I said, we record here almost every night, so that's the best part of it. And before I go, this is one of the 5 microphones used in the 50s here by Sam Phillips. We call it the Elvis microphone, but basically all the artists who recorded here used it at some point in the 50s, of course. And before he passed away, Sam Phillips gave it to us. I think it was just something of his personality, because he said he didn't want it behind the glass in a museum somewhere. He wanted people who care about this history to be able to touch it and take pictures, of course. Just don't lick it, please. I hate that I have to ask, but seriously. But other than that, if you need some inspiration, inspiration, just get it from the best who definitely knew how to do it. My name is Claude. I'm going to be in Mary's office if you guys have any questions. I also have a booklet to hand you on your way out, so don't leave without it. Also, absolutely not required to tip your tour guide, but it's 100% appreciated. So thank you. Give us a hand.
You shake my nerves and you rattle my brain. Too much love drives a man insane.